This is Pastor Adrian, and this is the word of the day. So as many of you know, we're 2 days away from one of the greatest events in the life of the church. Of course, I'm talking about Good Friday, in which we celebrate the death and burial of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, the only good thing about it was the redemptive value or the blessing that the death of Jesus produced for us. But it was not good for Jesus. In fact, it was very brutal. It was very torturous to him. It was at the hands of the Roman Empire, who were experts at torture and at death. We celebrate the cross of Jesus Friday, but did you ever contemplate that we need to experience some death to some things in our lives in order that we may live? You see, to have an awareness of life, there has to be death. Here's how Paul says it to the church at Galatia. In 2:20, he says, "I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life that I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me." I've been crucified. I know Jesus died for me. Praise God for that. But I also understand that in order to safeguard myself from slipping into anything but the gospel, I've got to regularly put some things to death. I don't just receive what Jesus did for me. I have been crucified with him. I become an active participant in this crucifixion. And here's the principle: I no longer live. What Paul is basically saying is you must learn the art of dying. You must learn the art of putting some things away, because dead men don't get mad. Dead women don't get angry. We don't get upset with people behind us in traffic. Why? Because, well, we're dead. We don't get jealous. We don't gossip. We don't hate, because we're dead. So Christ lives in me, in you. In other words, I'm not letting my body call the shots. I'm now living by faith. We call this living the crucified life. Living the crucified life. Now, I'm sure none of you hearing this went, "Woohoo! Yeah, amen. Come on, pastor, preach it." Not one. But this is a principle that you will find all throughout scripture. If you want to stay consistent, you ready for this? If you want freedom, if you want real freedom in your life, where your life begins to flourish and you begin to truly experience life, not as the world would have you live, not as your own desires would have you live, but to truly be God's man or God's woman, this is it. You are to die to self. It can change your life forever. Jesus tells his disciples in Matthew 16, he says, "If anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it." Jesus introduces this concept of people who live their life to the full are the ones who are not living it based on their own desires and their own emotions. They practice a discipline that needs to be in your life, that needs to be in my life, and that is living the crucified life. They take up the cross. In other words, for you to really live life to the full, something has to die in order for you to follow Jesus. I no longer live, Paul says. I need to crucify the self. We literally need to get to the place where we say, "Lord, not only do I give you my life," that's your salvation moment, "but I want to die to myself as well." Let me show you a beautiful principle you can add to your daily discipline. It's found in 1 Corinthians 15:31. It says, "I die every day." Now, what does that mean? It means coming to the Lord every single day, almost like your salvation prayer, saying, "Lord, today, once again, I say yes to you and no to the plan of the enemy for my life. I thank you that all my sins are forgiven. Once again today, I ask that you take all of me and I give all of you, all of me to you. Lord, today, help me forgive those who have done wrong to me. Lord, today, I give you my attitude. I want to kill my flesh. I want to kill my attitude. I want you to have my attitude. I don't want my nature. I want your nature. And would you please replace it with love, with joy, with peace, with patience, with kindness, with faithfulness, with gentleness, with self-control. Can you put your fruit, the fruit of the Spirit, inside of me? Lord, this morning I give you my mouth. Everything that comes out of my mouth, let it be an instrument that builds people up, not tears them down. Lord, this morning I give you my ears. I'm going to hear some things, but I want to hear your voice. I want to be in tune with what you're saying to me. I don't want to hear the voice of the stranger. I want to hear your voice. Lord, I give you my hands, these spirit fingers, right? Let them do good for your glory. Let them never do harm to anybody. Lord, I give you my mind this morning. I want to think on things of above, like Philippians 4 says. Anything that is excellent and praiseworthy and pure, give me a good mind, Lord. I kill my natural mind. Let my mind be the mind of Christ. Lord, I give you my feet. Take me to the places where you want to go. Give me purpose. Give me direction. Give me mission today so that I can fulfill the great commission that you have purposed for me to do. The steps of a good man are ordered by you. And so, Lord, put some divine appointments in my way. If you have that prayer where you die to self, it changes everything. But let me tell you, there's a shelf life to that prayer, and it's only about 24 hours. We need to pray that prayer every day. So every morning when we wake up, we say, Lord, I want you to increase and me to decrease. More of you, Lord, and less of me. Lord, I humble myself before you today. I got a big, bad ego, Lord. I'm large and in charge, and I can be prideful at times, but not today, God, not today. I don't want that today. In fact, I just want you to be great today. I want to encourage you this morning with that thought. More of God, less of me, as we enter into this crucified life with Jesus today. What would it be like if you lived your life every day with this thought when you get up in the morning, Lord, help me crucify myself?